It is my pleasure to request Mr. K.V. Sridhar, popularly known as Pops, to come on stage. But a quick note on Pops, from humble beginnings as a Bollywood film billboard painter to the chief creative officer for India subcontinent of Leo Burnett, Pops has seen it all and today is widely respected as a creative leader in the Indian advertising. Pops has not just won more than a bounty of international medals, including 22 Cannes Lions and a Grand Global at the NYF, and a whole lot of other recognitions. Under his creative leadership, Leo Burnett India went to win the Agency of the Year in Leo Burnett Global Network twice. Pops is popularly known, is credited with the emergence of Leo Burnett as the creative powerhouse in India. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Pops.
Thank you, Monica. All that was advertising, don't believe. I think all of us, knowingly or unknowingly, do lots of good things, and we also do bad things. And our community of advertising, our community of marketers are no different. Because there are some good people, there are bad people. And fortunately, this world survives on good people. There are a billion good people for one Osama bin Laden, correct? And it is only, we know that all the good things, we know all the bad things, but in between black and white, there is a huge gray. And I was really, really appreciative of what the truth Dr. Sharda has pointed in the morning. It is not the real item numbers which are problem. You know, the people who wanted to be blatantly bad, nothing anybody can do to them. The people who want to do good, they're already there. But the issue is the people, a large section of people who belong to the midsection. It's not the top of the pyramid, not the bottom of the pyramid. It is the meat of the pyramid which is an issue. And a lot of times in life, only if we were to know, only if we were to be a little sensitive, probably we wouldn't have done the mistakes. In real life, they cost quite a lot and we understand and we don't commit those mistakes again. But when you are in advertising or media or in any of the fields where you have the power to influence many, you need to be a little more careful about what you say, what you do, because you can't afford to make mistakes. And if you make mistakes, you should be very well aware that you are making a mistake. So sometimes we cannot avoid, because as somebody said, clients are not there for philanthropy, nor we get paid for philanthropy. Neither I am an NGO, nor I am an activist, I am a human being. And then I make a living, and I've been brought up with good values. And then the more I use them in my life, I feel good. The same thing, the more I use them in my professional life, I feel good. Because to me, there is nothing called a professional life, there is nothing called personal life. You don't wear a different hat and then sit in an office saying that, oh, I'm creative. You don't wear a different hat at home saying that now I'm a husband, now I'm a father. Nobody does that, we are all human beings. I think this entire world is, everything begins with human beings, people, and ends with people. There's nothing in between. And it's only human beings who can help human beings. There's nothing called male, female, Indian, something else. If you were to see that way, there are a lot of things which we as a human beings, every day, we can do. I don't believe that we should run away as an individual saying that whatever I do will not matter because it's an ocean. There are 500 million women there suffering. What will happen if I do one little thing? But I am one of those who actually believe that it is only drops which make an ocean. if each individual were to do whatever we have been taught to do, whatever our conscience tells us to do, then it makes a huge difference. Well, even if it does not make a difference, you will have a good night's sleep because you have done something. And lots of times, believe me, most of the clients, they are not clients, they are human beings. I have not, 34 years I have been in advertising, I have not come across any client saying that, let us be racist. Let us actually propagate some criminal activity. Let us be biased towards something. Let us not have values. Let us propagate lies. Let us blackmail women. None of them. It is just that, you know, when we want to do something in our anxiousness, to do that, like little children who play for the chair, in musical chairs, we in that race tend to do many mistakes. Only if we were to sit back and then think what we have done every evening, probably we ourselves will know. Change must happen within ourselves. Change, unless the change happens within ourselves, it won't happen anywhere else. And that's what we try to do. When we do, I have found very, very little to absolutely no resistance from clients. I have never made a PowerPoint presentation to Tata saying that, you know, you are a honest company and then you have so many values. Let me use those values into your advertising. I never did that. But when you are actually doing something and they are there to support, because not because we wanted to do philanthropy, because each time we have a specific problem and communication is supposed to solve that problem. And then creativity is used for commerce, for them. But ultimately, creativity has the power to change the human behavior. And then if you were to use the power which you have, not only solve a client's problem, but also to solve human behavior problems. There are lots of human behavior. And it is like Birnbach said in his book, that advertising has the power to change the way society behaves. You can choose to do, you have a choice, you know, when you are actually sitting in front of doing any activity, you have a white paper in front of you, you can make a choice. Either you can do an ad, which actually go and then get some motorcyclist killed, or you can actually go and then do an ad, which actually helps more motorbike riders to survive and enjoy biking and also drive safely. And Birnbach did that exactly the same thing in mobile campaign. So what he did is, simple logic of commerce. If more people were to buy bikes, you will sell more of your oil. For more people to buy bikes, you must have more young people to be there on the streets to live. If people don't live, then they are not going to buy your product, correct? At the end of the day, we are selling it to people. Everything, there is nothing called consumer, there is nothing called SSE A, B, C, nothing called an MBA, nothing called a brand manager. At the end of the day, it's all people. When people treat people as people, the relationships are completely different. I must say, there are two things which are happening in this advertising and marketing world. One, the world has become transparent last 10 years. Nobody today, no brand in the world or no company in the world, no individual in any public life in the world today can hide behind anything. Because world is becoming transparent, it takes one tweet from Latin America to fire up an agitation here in Mumbai. So because the world is becoming transparent, has already become transparent, there is no other alternative for people except to behave and then to bow down to honesty. You cannot lie and survive. When companies are becoming honest, real honest, not tokenism, then their advertising, their behavior has to be that. You know, their DNA has to change. So lots of companies are changing across the world and they're becoming much more transparent. The second huge change which is happening across the world is everything has become a commodity. Whatever Samsung does, Apple can do it within no time. Whatever Apple does, Samsung can do it without any time. So what happens in this world is you don't buy products because one is better than others, because everybody is the same. you have a vitamin in your shampoo, somebody else will also have a vitamin E in their shampoo. So how do you discriminate one brand to another brand? Like, how do we make, there are so many people in this room, but not all of them are your good friends. Why do you make some of them as your friends? Ultimately, human beings get connected with other human beings because you share certain values. The same thing happens in advertising. The same thing happens with brands. You tend to spend more time and consume brands whose values, whose propagations, which you believe you are close to. If somebody is offending, you don't want to make a friendship with them. If somebody is nice to you and you share certain values, you want to spend more time with them. Today, our entire business, marketers have understood how to have a relationship, successful relationship and a fruitful relationship with the users. They're also human beings. So these are the two things which are changing, and then that's the reason why today, far more than before, values are so important. Values are important for human beings, and then they have been there. That's the reason why the world is still on, and then we are still living without any of those issues. In the same way, lot of advertising is changing, and lots of behavior of business houses are changing, and then the marketing and communication is changing because values are at the premium. You like, a lot of people said Jaguar, but Jaguar is not just selling the tea. What are they ultimately trying to sell? They are actually trying to say that awaken. Because when you say that wake up, it is also there within the brand, correct? At the end of the day, you are not only asking me to wake up with a good cup of tea, but also wake up to lots of other things. I like the value whether I do it or not. I like the value, therefore, I tend to associate with a brand which has got those values, exactly what we do in our real life. There's absolutely no difference. So that is what is making huge difference, and then hopefully this will bring an enormous change in the way lots of brands will advertise in the future. They have already started, and it will go on and then become much more significant everywhere. The same company, Hindustan Lever, Unilever across the world, 2 years back started with the entire thing, talk to your girls before the manufacturers do. And they really, really spoken to the mothers to really bring in awareness of little teenage daughters, how they fall prey to all these little chemicals and then cosmetics. So they are brands which are trying to do, maybe, you know, they are at very, very nascent stage and smaller stage. My submission is it is going to become much bigger, and then most of the brands will become like good human beings and then talk and then have good relationship. And then what I'm going to present is how the changes which we have done, little things, very small things, without anybody noticing, without anybody. You cannot go to a boardroom and then tell a client that I'm going to change the world and then you finance me. Nobody will accept that. If I go and then actually argue that it will be interesting to use a girl instead of a boy. Somebody has said, you know, that HSBC commercials, HDFC commercial of Papa. The Papa commercial, you know, the scholarship for the girl, it could have been a boy, correct? There's absolutely nothing. It was actually indeed written with a boy, and then only thing which I did, it was change that boy to a girl, and then I went, you know, that time the marketing director was Suresh Mahalingam, and then I know that he has two lovely daughters. He never opposed. And then the argument which I gave is, when have you last seen in advertising that a girl is being seen off to, actually, entire family is sending her off to get educated in some other country? You only see the bidai, that, you know, very sadful, mournful bidai, that she goes off to in-law's place. How progressive and how lovely that sight would be, and everybody has agreed, and then absolutely no, nothing, you know, no resistance from anyone. If you make it as an issue, people will actually go back. Nobody wants to be an activist. But people want to be good human beings. If you actually approach them as human beings and then tell them, isn't it would be lovely? The second one which we did, I'll just want to play that, is what brought in some change.
नई कार लेने में ही भलाई है, वो भी बड़ी वाली। बड़ी क्यों?
क्योंकि तुलिका शर्मा चाहती है कि उसके डैड स्टाइल से ट्रैवल करें।
एक्स्ट्रा पैसे तेरा डैड देगा क्या?
नहीं, मेरे डैड की बेटी।
इतने पैसे आए कहाँ से?
रिलैक्स डैड, प्लान किया है।
पर बेटा।
प्लीज डैड। अरे क्या हुआ?
कार बड़ी हो गई और बेटी भी।
यूनिट लिंक सेविंग प्लान्स फ्रॉम एचडीएफसी स्टैंडर्ड लाइफ। जिम्मेदारी निभाओ आज भी कल भी, सर उठा के जियो।
इट कुड हैव बीन यू नो द एंटायर इशू विद दिस व्हेन वी वर डूइंग दिस कैंपेन। इट कुड हैव बीन अ बॉय, इट कुड हैव बीन अ मैन और वुमन, इट रियली डज नॉट मैटर। बट द मोमेंट यू ट्राई एंड देन पोर्ट्रे वुमन सक्सेसफुली इन अ बेटर वे, समबडी हैज आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन व्हाई वी आर टॉकिंग टू वुमन, नो दिस इज टॉकिंग टू मेन, यू नो हाउ टू ट्रीट. And then if you see better images, and then if you can inspire people that how lovely to have a daughter like that. And then I have seen many people, I have daughter, and then she actually does gift me many things. And such lovely moments as human beings, you know, they touch you. And it was so successful that this year they launched a women's plan. This was not meant to be a women's plan. And this year they launched a commercial with women's plan. I want to show you another example of how little things can make a difference.
भाई साहब मुबारक हो।
राम दया जी, लड़की हुई है।
शुरू से ही आशा की जिंदगी सिर्फ इसीलिए कड़वी थी क्योंकि वो एक लड़की थी। उसकी जीत में भी उसे हार ही मिली।
पापा मैं और पढ़ना चाहती हूँ।
तेरी पढ़ाई पे खर्चा करूंगा तो शादी पे केक लाऊंगा। कद्दू
सपने देखने चाहे तो दुत्कार मिली।
भाई सब हम बढ़ाते हैं 1000 गज की कोठी। आप चाहे नीचे रह लियो फिर चाहे ऊपर रह लियो।
मैं कुछ बोलूं?
तुम विचार नहीं, आचार दो।
कदम बढ़ाती तो लगाम कसती जाती।
देखो बेटा एक्शन तो हम ले लेंगे लेकिन बदनामी आप ही की होगी। जब
अपनों के भेष में बेगानी मिले।
कथूरिया जी हमें नहीं पता किस मेहनत का फल मिला।
तालियों की आड़ में ताने मिले।
बराज आशा 1 करोड़ रुपए जीत गई है, बधाई हो आप।
धन्यवाद सर।
क्या कहना चाहेंगे आप?
मुबारक हो, लड़की हुई है।
क्या बात, समझ गया, लड़का लड़की का भेदभाव मिट जाता है। सिर्फ ज्ञान ही आपको आपका हक दिलाता है।
कैडबरी डेयरी मिल्क प्रेजेंट्स कौन बनेगा करोड़पति, पावर्ड बाय आइडिया, चलता रहा है सिर्फ सोनी पर।
The point is when you are writing stories, you have a white paper in front of you. You can write good stories, you can write bad stories, you can write stories out of your memory, you can write stories out of fiction, and then you can write stories preempting what people would react to them. You have all the choices, and then the choice you make is what makes who you are, and then we are what we see, and then what we have learned and what we have experienced in our life. And when people see the images in and out, that is what they have been seeing. And then they grow up, another generation of children will grow up with the images what they are seeing. Once a forum like this, I have had the opportunity of Menaka Gandhi with me. That point in time, you know, the Hutch dog was the biggest issue. And then she was going around suing everybody. Is Abhijit there? Yeah. Actually, she was. Yeah, I had actually spoken to Piyush about it. She wanted to sue everybody, and then after that, nobody wanted to use animals in advertising. Correct. I have told her, no, you have a Gandhi in your name. Please, don't scare our community away. If children are not supposed to see animals, how the hell they will have any affection for them? There are no circuses, there's absolutely no zoos, and there are no pets at home. देयर नो ट्रीज दे डोंट गो आउट एनीवेयर ऑन टेलीविजन इफ यू बैन एनिमल्स हाउ द हेल चिल्ड्रन आर गोइंग टू हैव एनी अफेक्शन फॉर एनिमल्स व्हाई यू बैन देम सो आफ्टर दैट एडवर्टाइजिंग कम्युनिटी वेंट टू कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स एंड यू सी ऑल द एनिमल्स टुडे आर ऑल कंप्यूटर जनरेटेड दे आर नॉट रियल एनिमल्स द इशू वॉज शी वॉज फाइटिंग वॉज वन पग यू नो दैट एंटायर कैंपेन हैज हैपेंड 50,000 pugs were imported into this country. 50,000 pups were imported into country, and then that was the most loved species in this country. Fantastic. But the problem was, this country was not ready to take on an animal which could not survive. And then a pug cannot give a natural birth. There are not enough number of vets in this country. And Lynn was also with me that time. And then not enough doctors were there who could take care of that. All it meant was one phone call to Piyush, one call to Vodafone, one call to Ogilvy. If they were to know, they would have used their networking and then actually helped every pug in this country. Probably they would have put up a network of doctors who could have actually taken care of them. Instead, they actually made them withdraw the ad. And then the point which I am making is positive. And then if you can influence people, and then if people are aware of what they are doing, most likely they will do something better than what they are doing. It is ignorance which is the worst enemy. Thank you.